My friends, Alex Jones here with key breaking news. It is April 18th, 2011. I told you more than 2 months ago when this whole Libya situation kicked off that NATO and the UN were planning to get us involved in another war and were preparing ground troops to invade Libya. When the UN passed their resolution, within 36 hours, President Obama had followed their orders, not consulted Congress, and launched a war, an air war against Libya. And when the public pointed out that you've got to get congressional approval under the Constitution to do that, or we might as well just have a Caesar or a Fuhrer, Obama's people came out and said, it's kinetic action, it's not a war. Now, even before this conflict started, U.S. and British-backed forces, SAS and other CIA commandos, were on the ground in eastern Libya working with the admitted al-Qaeda-affiliated groups against Gaddafi, who tried to make deals, and did make deals, 6 years ago to give up his WMDs and make nice with the West. But none of that even matters. Let's say you love Gaddafi, hate Gaddafi. The issue is the system thinks we're so dumb that they launched this new war and had the nerve to tell us that it wasn't a war and promised and swore there would never be a ground invasion. When you read the UN resolution, it talks about whatever force is necessary, and they've been massing troop ships with British and U.S. Marines off the coast going back into even early March. On March 2nd, more ships launched from the United States with Marines on board, saying they're ready for ground operations in Libya. And this is what's so sick about this new level of deception and how dumb the system thinks we are. They're saying it's a humanitarian force of 1,000 that's going to land and help the rebels in a humanitarian way open up roads and the seaways. And if the Libyan government gets in their way in any way, then they'll have to be a larger ground force because that evil Gaddafi dare attack the globalist military that was there helping the rebels attack them. They think the public is so stupid that if Libya fights back against bombardment from the air or ground troops, giving munitions and logistics to the al-Qaeda forces attacking Gaddafi, that that is some form of terrorism. This is the new model of imperial world government, where the UN, owned by the big central banks, launches rebel forces inside Egypt. When Egypt stands up against them, the West comes in and backs the overthrow of Mubarak, their old dictator. Same thing is being done in other Middle Eastern and North African countries. And the world realizes what's happening. That's why Saudi Arabia is running away in fear to Russia and China now and slashing oil production because they understand the West has turned on them. I'm not a fan of the corrupt Saudis either. The point is, why are the globalists destabilizing the world now? And why do the globalists think we are so stupid that Obama and the UN and the rest of them swore there'd never be ground forces when they already had SAS commandos and CIA advisors on the ground from before the conflict? This is amazing. So the ground force is getting ready, and now with Orwellian-type terms, they're telling us that this itself isn't a ground invasion, just like the air bombardment was not an air war. Ladies and gentlemen, it's breaking at Infowars.com. The London Guardian's also reporting on it. The EU is moving ahead with their invasion under UN authority, and all of this to legitimize the world government. This is how the imperial system invades countries. They have their rebels attack, and if their rebels aren't successful in taking over the nation, then the air power and the ground troops are brought in. This is incredible. And you've all been lied to arrogantly the whole time they knew that they were going to have this ground invasion and swore they'd never do it, treating us all like a bunch of idiots and trying to break our will and condition us to accept the fact that Western governments are a pack of liars. And they don't just want to enslave the Libyans or the Egyptians. Since they've put in a new government in Egypt, they've banned protest entirely and have the modesty police out in force. They want to take our liberties here at home as well. This is a global corporate government that wages war against any form of human liberty. And if we don't speak out against this new war, they're going to launch more and more and more, just like the French have now invaded the Ivory Coast and overthrown the government and brought in the rebels that were hacking people up with machetes. If we don't say no to this system, the globalists are not going to stop. They are launching a takeover all over the planet, and it's very dangerous. And it marks a major escalation in the neo-imperial takeover of the planet.
Visit Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. When you're on the site, you can also tune in 24 hours a day to my daily radio broadcast. There's also a free iPhone app to listen to the syndicated radio show when and where you want.